The Duke and Duchess of Cambridge have spent the day in Blackpool visiting a series of innovative projects focused on investment and regeneration, as well as learning how the resort is tackling some of the social and mental health problems faced by people in Britain today. Kate, 37, looked elegant as she kicked off her visit to the iconic seaside town alongside William, 36, with a visit to the iconic Blackpool Tower. The royal couple took part in a briefing about the town's recent history, the challenges, and the investment and regeneration efforts that are currently underway. Kate cut an elegant figure in the rain, opting for an olive £940 Sports Max coat, a £225 Michael Kors patterned peacock dress, and accessorised with a recycled £435 green Manu Atelier bag and black knee-high boots. The pair, sheltering under large black umbrellas, were greeted at the landmark mid the downpours with cheers from a crowd of several hundred well-wishers gathered outside on the promenade, including youngsters who charmed Kate with bunches of flowers. As one little girl shouted "Hello, Princess," Kate waved and smiled, and she also promised locals she would bring her three children George, Charlotte and Louis along on her next visit. William and Kate were met by local dignitaries including the mayor and mayoress of Blackpool, Gary, and Debbie Coleman, as they stepped inside for a briefing about the town's investment and regeneration projects. Once inside the historic tower, Kate and William briefly stopped at a giant mirror unveiled by the Princess of Wales in July 1992 to mark the opening of Tower World, with the Duke describing it as fantastic and amazing. The couple were then treated to a brief glimpse of the world-famous Tower Ballroom, which is open to the public daily. From their balcony view, they watched dancers go through their strides in a waltz to "I Shall See You Later," played on the Wurlitzer by Chris Hopkins. The pouring rain did not bother the couple, as they chose not to stand underneath the umbrellas being proffered by nearby aides. On a walkabout outside the tower as they visited the comedy carpet on the promenade, Kate told well-wishers she hoped to bring her children Prince George, Princess Charlotte and Prince Louis to visit Blackpool next time. She joked, "Is the weather always like this?" The Duchess expressed her disappointment at not going up the tower. "No, we didn't. Next time, I think. There's so much here the children would love as well. Hopefully next time we'll bring them back." Meanwhile, the Duke recalled his fond memories of Blackpool on a stag do. Pat Husson, 66, who had travelled down from Manchester recalled, he said he loved Blackpool and that he has been up and down the coast here when he was flying a helicopter. He said he had been here before for a stag party and that he had really enjoyed it. The royal couple were greeted by youngsters from Happy Tots Nursery, who gave them a posy, sticks of rock with their names running through it and some arts and crafts. These included a collage, a necklace of pictures, and a crown from a four-year-old called Jasmine. William said his children would appreciate the rock. When he asked them what flavor the rock was, the youngsters replied, "Blackpool." In the lineup was two-year-old Tommy, who became overwhelmed and had to be picked up by a staff member. His mother, Cassie, said, "He got all nervous and had to be picked up by one of the girls. He was so excited this morning and was practicing bows." Cheryl Hole, who works for Better Start, was also in the lineup along with her two-year-old daughter Felicia, who presented the Duchess with a posy. The Duke asked her name and how old she was. Nursery manager and owner Julie Bryan said, "The children have been busy all week making flags and crowns. We also made a poster of photographs of William and Kate, together with pictures of the children, which we presented to them. It was an amazing experience for everyone here and it is such a privilege to be part of it." They also presented a paper crown and garland to William. William kept it casual in a pair of navy blue trousers and matching blazer, layering a sweater with a pale shirt underneath as he waved at waiting crowds. Meanwhile, Andrea Bellamy, 31, had a moving conversation with the Duchess about mental health. She said, "I thanked her for everything she had done and told her that I had done a skydive for Place to Be where she is a patron. I told her how I had lost a close family member to suicide." She, the Duchess, said, "It's so important to keep talking about it," and asked if I had support. The Duke and Duchess of Cambridge continued their day with a visit to Blackpool Central Library, where they joined two separate discussions focusing on issues and initiatives of particular relevance to each of their ongoing charitable interests. The Duchess met with members involved in Blackpool's A Better Start charity program, including health visitors, practitioners from the Family Nurse Partnership, and parents. During the first session, William and Kate met teenage mum Chloe Roberts, 18, from Blackpool and her mentor Lynn McKinnon, a family nurse supervisor in the town. Chloe found herself homeless after falling pregnant and was forced to live in hostels with her newborn son St. James last year. She said, "I don't know where I'd be without Lynn and the project. They've helped me so much from when I basically found myself homeless to living in hostels to learning how to actually look after my son. No one judges you, they are just there to help, and I didn't know about anything at the start when he was born." Listening intently and nodding, Kate replied, "That's what I find so interesting, how our own experiences shape how we develop and learn ourselves." Meanwhile, during a roundtable meeting on the investment and regeneration efforts that are currently underway, William addressed the challenges facing the town. The Duke began by saying that Blackpool is one of the most loved seaside towns in Britain, but that there is a sadder side to Blackpool, which we will be seeing a bit of today. He talked about how they would be seeing the new future planned for Blackpool. Speaking about its history, he described how it was once a jewel in the crown of the British tourism industry before people began to travel further afield for their holidays, and it faced economic decline and unemployment. Dispiritingly, those challenges are felt very strongly today, and they are more pressing than ever. He spoke of high unemployment rates and social problems, but also highlighted the positive moves, regeneration, and brilliant schemes, including a new enterprise zone and exciting new investment in Blackpool's iconic tourist attractions and innovative housing projects. William added, "The story of Blackpool is a complex one of a proud history of testing times and newfound optimism for the future." The Duke of Cambridge told two recovering drug addicts he was so proud of you guys after they explained how an initiative in Blackpool helped get their lives back on track. Best friends Louise West, 34, and Stephen Brown, 40, who described themselves jokingly as the other Wills and Kate, met the royal couple during a visit to Blackpool Central Library, where they heard about a number of mental health projects in the town. One scheme was Jobs, Friends, and Houses, which help sex offenders to transform and better their lives with around-the-clock support to help them find employment and provide accommodation. Ms. West told William and Kate how she became addicted to drugs from the age of 13 but had not used for 2 years. She said she left Holden, where she was a victim of domestic violence, to go to Blackpool near her mother. She said she was working on her recovery every day, but she had started to enjoy life and had even sat her GCSEs at the same time as her daughter. With her 17-year-old daughter at sixth form college, Ms. West said she would like to study psychology in the future. Ms. West told the couple, "Somebody said to me that meeting the royals would be one of the highlights of your life, but the highlight for me was recently when I dropped my daughter off at her friend's house and she asked me to come in and meet her friend's parents. That had never happened before. She was embarrassed to walk past me in the street in Oldham when I was 6½ stone. Kate asked her, "What's your main message to people?" Ms. West replied, "Any addict can get clean and stay clean." Mr. Brown told the Duke and Duchess he used drugs from the age of 12, was in prison for the first time at 17, and had been in and out of prisons for 20 years. He said, "I was being a nightmare for the police, if I'm honest, because I was a prolific offender in Blackpool. When I came out of prison, I was put in hostels. Some of them are really rough and people are using in there. In 2009, my brother bought a bag of heroin. It was laced with anthrax and he died. I tried to commit suicide. I would commit crime when I got out of prison and would hurt my family. I didn't know people could get clean in Blackpool." William said, "It is a vicious circle, and it is how do you break that circle? Was reaching rock bottom after your brother, what was the realization?" Mr. Brown said, "I have had loads of rock bottoms. Most of my friends had died. I had had enough one day in prison and made the decision for the first time in my life to stop taking drugs. William told the pair, "I am so proud of you guys. We will never truly understand what you have been through, but you should take great strength from where you are now." The royal couple also learned more about Blackpool's A Better Start program, one of five such 10-year projects in the UK funded by the National Lottery Community Fund. Merle Davis, the director of Blackpool's Centre for Early Child Development, discussed the impact of long-term investment in mothers, fathers and children in their early years. Meanwhile, Kate and William's joint engagement came as Harry, 34, and Meghan, 37, made a surprise appearances on stage at children's charity We Day star-studded event in London's Wembley today. The Duke of Sussex made a speech on stage, cheered on by his pregnant wife, who looked business chic in black skinny jeans and a navy blazer. The princes and their wives have had a busy week of engagements, and were pictured together for the first time since Christmas as they celebrated Prince Charles' 50 years of service at a Buckingham Palace reception thrown by the Queen yesterday.